Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the second part of section 3 of Surah Yaseen, where we've been looking at the different ayah, the different signs of Allah in the world all around us. We looked at the ayah of the dead earth, which Allah revives and brings forth from it habban, the staple food of grain. Then he gives us the luxury of different tastes, nakhil, inab, thamarihi, foods that sustain us. Then we looked at the ayah in the universe, the shams, the qamar that is in manazil, in phases that allows us to tell the time. The planets, falaki yasbahun, that float in an orbit without crashing, all in perfect order. And now in verse 41 of Surah Yaseen, Allah draws our attention to the ayah of transport, the sign of transport. And he specifically says, an ayah to them is the fulki, the ship. And it was then and probably still is now an incredible and important invention, carrying cargo and people across the seas and oceans. This massive structure, how is it that Allah has allowed the laws of nature to allow it to float on the water, this huge ship? But Allah doesn't just say it's the ship, he says, and we have created for them what is similar to it, which they ride. Now, this could have been horses and camels then, and it's maybe cars and lorries and bikes now, forms of transport that we depend on to get to different places. Now, you might think, hang on, those are not inventions of Allah, they're inventions that man, we have ourselves created. And you're right, they're not directly creations like we looked at before, like the sun and the moon and the earth. But who is it that gave man the power and the intellect and the ability to come up with such incredible inventions? The aeroplane, oh my gosh, something that flies in the sky and carries us. That's amazing that man has been given such an ability to create this. But hang on, don't get too arrogant. Allah says in ayah 43, and if we were in nasha' nughriqhum, if we drown them, nughriqhum, then who would help them? And who would come to their rescue? So yes, you might have created these things, but it is only because Allah has allowed the environment around us to accommodate these inventions that cause them to work. If oil didn't burn, if metals weren't magnetic, if water didn't allow things to float on, then would these inventions be of any use? No. It is Allah ultimately who is in control of it. If he is the one that makes the aeroplane stay up in the air, he is the one that keeps the boat afloat. So Allah reminds us, illa rahmatan minna. It is except by a mercy from us. It's not because we deserve these blessings. Rather, it is out of his kindness. And he says, "It's enjoy them, it's fine. But he reminds us, it's temporary. It gives you comfort only for a short while. And then Allah says, in ayah 45, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ اِتَّقُوا. And when it is said to them, اِتَّقُوا, be aware, safeguard yourselves from what is behind you and from what is in front of you, so that you may receive mercy. So what's behind us is our past, and what's in front of us is our future. And if you are ittaku, if you are on guard, if you are aware, then you will think of your past and you will seek forgiveness for anything you've done wrong. And if you are on guard, then you will think of your future and be careful of the way that you behave and of your actions. And then Allah says, after all these signs that he showed us, we are in such awe of his glory. Subhanalladhi. How incredible is this, Allah? But yet Allah says in ayah 46, there are still people where a sign comes to them, a sign from their Lord, but they turn aside from it. Do you remember the Ghafilun, those who are heedless? They see these signs and yet they ignore them. They're distracted. They reject them. But once you have believed in these signs, Allah says, it is said to them, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ أَنْفِكُوا. When they are told, spend out of what Allah has given you, those who disbelieve tell those who believe, what? Should we feed those who, if Allah wanted, He could feed? So they are saying there are still people in the world who are hungry. We hear it all the time. Why isn't Allah feeding them? Why are there these starving people around the world? But we forget that's our duty. We are Allah's ambassadors on this earth. It is our duty to share the blessings that Allah has given us. Allah has created enough food for everyone in the world, but it is because of us not sharing that food, not distributing it equally, that there are areas and parts of the world that are left without. But once we have acknowledged that everything we have is from Allah, then it becomes much easier to anfiku, to spend out of what Allah has given us. And just a side note, but all the ayah up to now, we're now on ayah 47, and up till now, every ayah of Surah Yasin has focused on belief. Believing in Allah, believing in the messengers, the mursaleen, believing in kitab, the Holy Quran, the Book of Wisdom. Every verse has talked about belief, but now it's the first verse where Allah is asking us to take a practical action, and that is anfiku. Now that you have believed in Allah, you've accepted that everything is from Him, you know that you're going to go back to Him. Do you remember that? Yeah, you're going to go back to Him. I was going to say something which we haven't covered yet, so you'll have to listen out to part the next section when we talk about lessons from the past. But once you've agreed and believe in Allah, then that's not where it stops. Allah's saying that's great, but now you've got to act on that belief. Anfiku, spend out of what Allah has given you. Share the blessings that you have, because you know it's all from Allah. So belief is not just belief in the heart, but it's actions with your limbs, like Imam Ali has said. And Islam, when asked by the Holy Prophet to be summarized in one sentence, he said it was obedience to Allah and serving the creation. So saying we believe but not acting and not looking after and serving those around us is not complete belief. Anfiku, spend. And what a beautiful month to be reminded of this, whether that is spending your wealth, your money, and sharing your blessing in that way, or anfiku, spending and sharing your time, looking after your siblings, sharing your knowledge, helping them with their homework. Anfiku, mimma, anfiku, razaqnahum, spend out of what Allah has given you. Because that's a way of thanking Him, acknowledging that everything we have, look around you, all these signs that we discussed, everything is from Allah. To Him we will return. And our job is to use what He's given us in His way. So let's do a quick recap of, there's not that much vocabulary to complete in this section, but we looked at fulki, ship, nughriqhum, drown, and ittaqu, coming from taqwa, to be aware, and anfiku, spend. And that concludes section 3. We now will begin the last two sessions where we look at the future destination. What has Allah got in store for us? What is in the life to come? Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.